Hello to everyone. I'm very happy to be here. I'd like to say to thank the organizer. My name is Eduardo Teste and I work in Bariloche with Horacio Cassini. This work was also done in collaboration with Gonzalo Torroa and is based in these two papers. I will start mentioning these known results about the C and F theorems due to Cassini and Huerta, which is based on two main things. The first one of which is that the universal piece of the entanglement entropy of a sphere in a CFT is believed to be ordered under RG flows, so the entanglement entropy is very sweet to approach this RG flows irreversibility theorems. And the second is this strong suavitivity inequalities for the entanglement entropy or Neumann entropy, where A and B are subalgebras, and this is the union and the intersection. So this, in general, this strong suavitivity inequality lets, when applied to the vacuum, lets you to allows us to prove in two and three dimensions the three, the C and F theorems. And in general, it lets you to a second order inequality, so there is some hope to reach the case of D equal 4, which is called the A theorem. So we led to the following questions, that is, for the vacuum, which subalgebras saturate the strong suavitivity inequalities? And this has a very nice geometrical answer. You need to take the regions A and B, such as its null future horizon lies in the same plane in general for the vacuum of any QFT. And for the case of a CFT, we have a better statement, which is that this, the null horizon of this region can also lie in a null cone. So we have proved this, that we have called the Markov property of the vacuum, because the state that saturates the strong suavitivity inequalities has this name. And we have proved this by three methods, one algebraic general, and one of which gives us an explicit expression for the modal Hamiltonian of these regions, regions whose has his null future horizon on a plane. So this has other, this Markov property has other interesting consequences in quantum field theory that we are working on now. But for the moment, we have applied to this, to obtain the entropic proof of the A theorem. And the way we have to do that is just take the full and strong suavitivity inequality for the vacuum of the RG running quantum field theory, and the saturation of it for the vacuum of the ultraviolet CFT, which is Markovian. And adding it, you had a better improved inequalities between a difference of entanglement entropies. So in this point, we can repeat this idea that was used in the F theorem to apply the strong suavitivity inequality in a symmetric form, which with these boosted spheres on the light cone. And the problem of the wiggly sphere that appeared then are solved because we can substitute then the difference of the wiggly spheres by difference of smooth spheres. And there is no such angle contribution problem because the surface are on a null cone. And there are a problem of difference in local curvatures, but this can be fixed because it is a ultraviolet problem and canceled between this difference. So at the end, we arrive at this general inequality valid in all dimensions. And when we apply it to the case of D equal 4, we obtain a cleanly inequality between the Euler trace anomaly, which this is the A theorem, and adding to this the known result of the C and F theorem, we have a unified picture of RG irreversibility from the point of view of entanglement entropy. And thank you.
Questions? In 2+1 dimensions, when you want to make those boosted spheres, you can do it in a very symmetrical way, which you actually had on one of your slides. But on in 3+1 dimensions, we can't make boosted spheres in such a nice way, because we can't, in a symmetrical way, pick a lot of points on a sphere. And I wonder if that's a problem in the argument.
I don't hear properly.
Is the microphone not working? In 2+1 dimensions, in a nice symmetrical way, yes. Many boosted circles yes. On the light cone.
Yes.
In 3+1 dimensions, you can't do it so nicely.
Yes, you can put a boosted sphere on a light cone also.
You can, but you can't take many of them in a symmetrical fashion.
You can put several rotated. They are rotated on the special solid angle.
Well, for your argument, you'd like them to uniformly fill the sphere. And you can't do that exactly. Maybe you can do it well enough.
I don't understand. What okay, well, maybe we can talk later. Yes.
It's just that there aren't enough regular polygons. On a circle, there's a regular n-gon for every n. But on a two-sphere, there aren't a lot of regular polyhedra, whatever they're called.
Well, we can talk later.
Hi.
Hello.
I was wondering if you could relate the earlier talk about ambiguities in computing entanglement for gauge fields, U1 gauge fields.
Sure. If you compute entanglement entropy using the regularization of mutual information, there is no problem with the gauge theories. That's my answer. You can compute the entanglement entropy using several regularizations. If you use the one that uses the mutual information, which has the property of being monotonic under inclusion of algebras, there is no such problem with the gauge theories. You will obtain a good result without ambiguities. Yes. Sure.
Okay, let us thank Eduardo again.